There's nothing that gets me more than these freaking rats eating my seeds. We just spent all day yesterday getting these seed trays all laid out to get my food for summer ready. And you can see it just got invaded by rats and all these seeds are dug up and eaten. I'm so pissed. And I even set a whole booby trap over here for them and they just ignored it. I might have to eat these rats just because they're pissing me off.
Any luck with our rat endemic? I put out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 landmine rat traps. And only one of them's been unset. And look at my seeds, even more of them are dug up here. It pretty much looks like they ate all the squash and all the melons. This morning I'm gonna try and use the half cup byproduct from my sourdough starter to make some pancakes. Instead of adding regular flour to thicken it up, I'm gonna add the acorn mash. You can see that this stuff is pretty sweet because it dried, but look, it just turns right back into flour. It looks like a buckwheat pancake. Really delicious. It is very like nutty and toasted. The flavor of that is certainly better than a normal pancake. I'm glad I figured out that acorn thing. The fox hide has patches where it's fairly soft and patches where it's really stiff. To be honest, I saw all these holes in it and splotches about 9/10 of the way through the softening process. I figured it wasn't worth the time, so I probably stopped a little early, and otherwise this part I think would have softened up. I just caught something that I've never caught before. Blue-tailed skink. How insane is that? What's up, buddy? How's it going? Whoa! We're gonna have these rampicante squash are just going off right now in March, which is amazing because my starts haven't even popped up yet, my squash starts. Unfortunately, without hand pollinating, these will not turn into squash generally. So I'm gonna give you a little demonstration on how to pollinate squash. So on the flower, there is usually male and female components. And some plants have male and female in one flower, and other plants have male flowers or female flowers. And then there's very rare, very strange plants like chirimoya, where they open in the morning and they're like male, and then they close, and then they open in the evening and they're female. So squash has male and female flowers separately. So like here's a nice specimen, right? This is so obviously female because it has a little baby squash on it. This is a zucchini, I guess, at this point. You can also tell because in here, that is the pestle. So that looks more like a female sex organ. I don't know what you want to call it. If you look down here, this is male squash flower. See, there's no squash on it. If you look in there, that is more phallic. It's just one kind of point. That's the stamen, which as you can see is covered in pollen, which is a dead giveaway that this is a male flower, which seems to be the way with most flowers. You can pretty much tell they either look like male or female sex organs. So once you've picked your male flower, you got to peel off the actual petals. You just after that pollen, it's a lot easier to get it without the petals in the way. You want to gently lift up your female flower and just take your male and put some of the pollen from the stamen onto the pestle. You can usually do about 3 or 4 squash flowers, females, with one male. Before I learned this, I found that my squash would kind of like set. It would look like there was a fruit developing, and then it would just start shriveling up from the tip and just kind of died. And I never knew why. I was always perplexed, but that's because it starts to develop and then it's not pollinated, so it just doesn't go. Even those zucchini that aren't pollinated are really good to eat. So if you see one that starts to shrivel on the tip that didn't get pollinated, chop it off and eat it. Another great thing to do is just to pick these really young ones like this with the flower on them and everything, and fry them up. Desert, valley, hard, for
just got startled pretty good in the greenhouse, Lewis. Baby gopher snake, huh? Hopefully this guy will work a lot better than my rat traps, which don't seem to be working at all. Happy hunting, buddy. I'm excited. This is my first chioga beet that I've grown. Supposedly, these have like rings on the inside of white and red. You can see here they have cool stripes on the stems of the leaves, which are really tasty and quite beautiful. So let's see how stripy this is on the inside. Pretty cool. It's gonna be pretty delicious too.
Came in to get some produce and I just saw a rat run under this bathtub.
Here he is, that little bastard. Oh.
I thought I could spear that rat with this broad-tipped arrow, but he's gone. Maybe I injured him. It's like I'm paranoid every night about him eating my little starts.
Make a nice chew toy for a dog, I suppose.